Hey guys, welcome to today's video where we're going to talk about the volume and surface area of a cone. We know that a cone is actually a lot like a pyramid. While a pyramid has a square base that connects to a pointy tip at the opposite end, a cone's base is instead a circle. Before diving into the details, let's make sure you're comfortable with the concepts of volume and surface area. These are two key features that all three-dimensional shapes have. Volume is the space inside a 3D object, and surface area is, well, just that. It's the total area of the surface of a shape. Think of volume as the amount of liquid that you could fill an object with, and think of surface area as how much paper you could wrap over that object. Every cube, sphere, cylinder, cone, of course, and so on has a volume and a surface area, and the formulas for each of these measurements is different for each shape. In the case of a cone, our volume formula looks like this. Volume equals 1/3 pi r squared h. And our surface area formula looks like this. Surface area is equal to pi r squared plus pi r l, where r, h, and l represent different measurements on the cone. But which measurements do these letters, or as we call them in the math world, variables, represent? The r represents the radius of the circular base of the cone. The h represents the height of the cone. More specifically, it's the length of an imaginary line that runs from the center of the circular base to the very tip of the cone. Finally, the l represents the slant height. Think of this as a straight line that runs from the tip of the cone to the edge of its base. So, to solve the volume and surface area equations, we'd simply plug a cone's measurements into the respective variables. Let's try a quick example. Say we have a cone whose base radius measures 3 units, height measures 4 units, and slant height measures 5 units. First, let's find its volume. So, volume is equal to 1/3 pi r squared h. So, we're going to rewrite this formula. We know that our radius is equal to 3, so we're going to substitute 3 in for r, and our height is equal to 4. So when we multiply this out, we get volume is equal to 1/3 pi times 9 times 4, which is 1/3 pi times 36, which is equal to 12 pi. So the volume of this cone is 12 pi, or approximately 37.7 cubic units. Notice that volume is measured in units cubed. Think centimeters cubed, inches cubed, feet cubed, or cubic feet, etc. Okay, now let's find the surface area of this little guy. So surface area is equal to pi r squared plus pi r l. Then we'll substitute in the numbers for our variables. So pi times 3 squared plus pi times 3 times 5. So surface area is equal to pi times 9 plus pi times 15, which is equal to 24 pi. In the end, we'd say that the surface area is 24 pi, or approximately 75.4 square units. Notice the way that's measured. Since we were talking about area, we use square units. It's pretty straightforward to plug in values for r, h, and l, right? Well, what if we wanted to figure out what size ice cream cone we would need in order to fit 30 cubic inches of soft serve into it? Because we can only have one unknown variable in an equation right now, and because we already know the volume of this cone, 30 cubic inches, we'll need to decide on a fixed value of either the cone's height or the base's radius. Let's say that we want the cone to be exactly 10 inches in height, so h equals 10 inches. Now, all that's left is to figure out what r equals. In other words, we need to find out how wide the opening of this cone gets. First, we set up the volume equation using all the information we already have. So volume is equal to 1/3 pi r squared h. And our volume is equal to 30 cubic inches 1/3 pi stays the same. We're looking for r, so we're going to leave that as r squared, and h is 10 inches. So if we rearrange a little bit, we'll get this. 30 equals 10/3 pi r squared. Now we're trying to get r all by itself on one side of the equal sign. So to do this, we're going to multiply both sides by 3 over 10 pi. When we do this, multiply by 3 over 10 pi on the left, 3 over 10 pi on the right, and that gives us 90 over 10 pi is equal to r squared. Then we can simplify this further to get 9 over pi is equal to r squared. Then all we have to do is take the square root of both sides. So when we do this, we get 3 over root pi is equal to r, which is approximately equal to 1.7. In fact, since the linear dimensions of the cone are measured in inches, we know that r is approximately 1.7 inches. Okay, cool. So what if we want to figure out the surface area of that cone we were just talking about? We now know the three important measurements of this cone: its volume, its height, and its base's radius. Remember that in our surface area equation, we need both the radius and the slant height of the cone in order to find the surface area. Believe it or not, we can calculate the slant height by using the h value that we were given and using the r value that we just found. We just need to use the Pythagorean theorem. Let's look at this particular cross-section of our cone. Since this is a right triangle, we can use r squared plus h squared equals l squared to find the hypotenuse, which is the slant height. Let's work that out. Remember, we just saw that r squared equals 9 over pi. So we can substitute 9 over pi in for r squared, plus h squared, h is 10, 10 squared is 100, so plus 100 equals l squared, which we're looking for l. Now we're going to want to simplify our addition on the left side. So we're going to keep 9 over pi the same, and then we're going to need a common denominator for both of these parts. So we're going to do that by multiplying 100 by pi over pi. When we do that, we get 100 pi over pi equals l squared. Now we have the same denominator in both our fractions, so we can add them like normal. 9 plus 100 pi over pi equals l squared. Now all that we have to do is take the square root of both sides. When we do this, we get that l is approximately 10.1. So our slant height is approximately 10.1 inches. Awesome. Now let's use this to find the surface area. Surface area is equal to pi r squared plus pi r l r is approximately 1.7 plus pi times 1.7 times 10.1. Then if you plug this into a calculator, you'll get that surface area is approximately equal to 63 square inches. And that's it. By just knowing the cone's volume and height, we were able to find its radius, its slant height, and its surface area. I want to work one more example together. But first, let me tell you about how ancient mathematicians came up with these volume and surface area formulas. Why do we divide pi r squared h by 3 in the volume equation? And why are we only concerned with the r and l values when we find surface area? To answer that first question, there's one fact you need to know. A cone has a volume that's 1/3 the size of a cylinder's volume, as long as they have the same size circular base. Let's take a look. The r and h values of these two objects are the same, and we know that the volume equation of a cylinder is v equals pi r squared h. Hence, since this cylinder could hold 3 times the amount of stuff inside of it, we have that the volume of the cone is equal to pi r squared h over 3. As for the cone's surface area, we need to consider the two different sides of this 3D shape. We have a circle sitting on the bottom, and we have this curved surface connecting the base to the endpoint. So we need to add the area of the circle, remember that's pi r squared, to the area of the curved piece, which is pi r l. With all of this in mind, let's look at our final example. Say we have a huge cone whose base's diameter measures 10 feet, height measures 12 feet, and would need a 13-foot-long rope to connect a straight line from the tip to the edge of the base. We know how to find this cone's surface area and volume. First, let's work on the volume. Again, we have that volume equals 1/3 pi r squared h. But remember, we were given the diameter of the circular base, not its radius. We couldn't just plug the 10 into the r's place in that equation. Instead, we use what we know about the relationship between diameter and radius. A circle's radius is half of its diameter, so this cone's radius is actually 5 feet. And now finding the volume is pretty straightforward. So if we plug in the variables that we know, we get 1/3 pi times 5 squared times 12, which is equal to 1/3 pi times 25 times 12, or 1/3 pi times 300, which equals 100 pi. So the volume is 100 pi cubic feet. Finally, let's find the surface area. Surface area is equal to pi r squared plus pi r l. When we plug in our known variables, we get pi times 5 squared plus pi times 5 times 13. Surface area is equal to 25 pi plus 65 pi, which is equal to 90 pi square feet. So we see that we would need 90 pi square feet of wrapping paper to cover this thing. Well, I hope that this has given you a greater understanding of cones and has made you confident in your ability to find any cone's volume and surface area. Thanks for watching and happy studying.